When you get to your wits' end, you'll find that God lives there. Welcome, my beautiful brothers and sisters, connecting from all over Mother Earth. On this Casa Day, as the current flows fluidly, freely and easily, from the portal of the Casa de Don Ignacio, the house of love, where the medicine is love, directly into our hearts, connecting us, one family, right across the globe. From Abidjania in the heart of Brazil. And we have another gorgeous day here. Dare I call it even winter time. It's cooler in the mornings and just spectacular during the day. Deep blue skies, the colour of the mantle of our Divine Mother Mary, her love and protection, the colour of the casa. And the odd white fluffy cloud, gorgeous Abidjania skyscape, and they're moving slowly by, reminding us of our transformation, and that all things pass, all things are impermanent, and we are just travellers here on earth. So wherever you are in the world, relax. If you're lying down, great. If you're under a crystal bed, super. And if you prefer to sit upright as we do here in the current, feet firmly on the ground to ground us. Don't cross your body in any way. Be open to give and receive and allow this miraculous high vibration to flow through all of our chakras, pouring forth from the center of our being. Our hearts joining us, brothers and sisters in the light, right across the world in this sacred moment. And put a glass of water beside you. This is blessed, and we drink it at the end of the work to nourish us, mind, body, and spirit. And as we close our physical eyes, which is totally necessary for this divine connection, the best sight is insight. We leave the material world behind with all of its many challenges, problems, difficulties. And we open our spiritual eyes, where we can see beyond appearances, all there is. We are reminded again and again that we're spiritual beings having a human experience, and not the other way around. We're not the body, we're much more than we could ever imagine. The body merely houses our eternal spirits. We're not living eternally in these physical bodies. We have an expiration date. We move in and out of perishable bodies, and we have come through lifetimes to be here together in this sacred moment. And we have an infinite amount of help available to us from beyond the veil. So many entities of light and love, all messengers from the source. And today we just take a little time out to consider God, an absolutely gigantic, infinite subject. And we are reminded that God is everywhere and in everything. And that, bidden or not, God is always present. And who is God? This is the priceless question, really. And particularly now with this massive wake-up call on Earth, we are wondering, why would God do this to us? Or some of us are connected on a higher level, knowing that everything is transient. But certainly there seems to be so much chaos as we rise above the material world and realize that we are infinite spiritual beings. And God is seen as the supreme or ultimate reality, the being in perfect power, wisdom and goodness, who is worshipped in many religions, Judaism, Christianity, Islam and Hinduism, and is seen as the creator and ruler of the universe. And the teachings of Spiritism that come through the Casa are very much with the Christ consciousness, which teaches that God creates the universe. And there are seven names of God that were once written and that cannot be erased because of their holiness. They are the Tetragrammaton, El, Elohim, Eloha, Eloi, Eshada, and Tremot. However, we can get caught up in a lot of definitions, and really it takes away from the essence of God. I like to call God the sacred trinity of innumerable names. As when we were growing up, we were put in fear of God, and we thought that God was sitting on a cloud like Santa Claus, doling out goodness to good children and not so goodness to not so good children. So we were really in fear of this deity. And we need to understand that God is a spirit, infinite, eternal and unchangeable. And we tend to call him a masculine figure, but he is, of course, all-wise, powerful, holy, and is so much involved with justice, goodness, and truth. And in monotheistic thought, God is conceived as the supreme being, the creator deity, and the principal object of faith. God is usually conceived as being omnipotent, which is all-powerful, omniscient, which is all-knowing, omnipresent, which is all-present, and omnibenevolent, which is all-good. He is the creator of the universe, which is matter, energy, space, and time. And God is not just the creator of the universe and leaves it to our own faith. God is so much more than the creator of the universe. He is the source. And in Christian tradition, God is the personal being who walked and talked with Adam and Eve, the first human beings in the Garden of Eden, and the saviour of mankind, coming to earth in the person of Jesus of Nazareth to provide the ultimate example of holiness and the ultimate sacrifice for humanity's evilness. In order to restore our personal relationship with him. And in Christianity, which is what we really deal with through the portal of the Casa, God is the self-existent one, having no need of being created, since he has existed forever and is the cause of all things, including the dimension of time, to which he is not subject. Likewise, God is not subject to the physical creation, but is spiritual in nature, residing in the spiritual dimensions of heaven. As above, so below. God is in heaven, but God is also with us here on earth. And God never abandons us. So we really are in awe of this amazing high vibration of the God consciousness, because God's power over the physical creation is absolute, and God can manipulate matter, energy, space and time at will. And God is all powerful, all knowing, and able to accomplish any task that he wills us to do. And at the end of the day, God is all loving. And I like to think of this beautiful deity that oversees the entire masterpiece of creation as love. That God is love. And we are part of this enormous infinity of love, which is practically indescribable. So we are basically love and light and part of the God consciousness. So with this phenomenally high vibration and this understanding of something that's so hard to grasp, bigger than us for sure, bigger than the universe even, let us pray. The prayer of Caritas, divine love. Love is all there is, and love never ends. And let us offer this almighty vibration upwards towards the heavens, asking the God of our lives, whoever or whatever God means to you, to help us in these very challenging times now on earth to connect with the higher power, something godlike, that rules over the universe and that really is within us and inexplicable as we navigate these challenging times on earth. Let us pray with open hearts, without ceasing, joyfully, happily, knowing that our prayers have been answered, always and in always, by an ever listening God consciousness. O Father, Mother, God, Sacred Trinity of innumerable names, provide strength to those who are experiencing pain and anguish. Give light to those who seek the truth. Fill the human heart with compassion and love. God, give the traveller the star that guides, solace to those in pain, and rest to the sick and weary. Father, give the guilty repentance, the spirit, the truth. Give the child guidance, the orphan a parent. Lord, let your goodness encompass everything that you have created. Clemency, my God, to those who do not know you. Hope to those who are in pain. Let your will allow the consoling spirits to spread peace, hope, and faith everywhere. God, may a single ray of light, a spark of your divine love, blaze this earth. Let us drink from the fountain of that infinite and fruitful goodness, and all tears will be dried, and all pain lessened. A single heart, a single thought will rise to you like a cry of gratitude and love. Like Moses on the mountain, we await you with open arms. O Almighty, O Greatness, O Powerful, O Beauty, O Perfection. And we wish in some way to receive your mercy. God, grant us the power to help progress, that we may rise up to you. Give us pure love. Give us faith and reason. Give us humility and simplicity that will make our hearts and our souls the mirror on which your divine image reflects. Amen.
Sem nenhuma explicação. Que desce como fogo.
Be still and know that I am God. In the silence of our hearts, God speaks to us. God speaks to us always and in all ways. God speaks vibration. And we need to open our hearts, which is our mission on earth, to receive the word of God. And many of us now in this challenging time on earth are looking for God like God could ever get lost. We're looking for something tangible that we can touch and feel and something solid. But God is fluid. And there is this need to find God like he's lost or something. And God cannot be found in noise and restlessness. God is the friend of silence. God is the creator who created everything in the universe itself. And if we sit and look at nature, trees, flowers, grass, they grow in silence. When we see the stars, the moon and the sun, they move in silence. God is speaking to us through this vibration of silence. We need silence to be able to get in touch with our souls. We may ignore however we nowhere can we evade the presence of God. The world is crowded with God. God walks everywhere incognito. Who gives us our breath that we don't even think about, that keeps us physically alive? It is God. And many of us remember the sign in the Casa, silence is a prayer. When we sit in silence, there's so much activity around us. Here in Abidjan, it's amazing how alive creation is. And when we follow our breath, we can feel the presence of God. And we need to realize that the Casa de Dominatio welcomes all belief systems, all creeds, all colours. Everyone is welcome at the Casa, or even to send a petition down here without actually coming here. And all prayers are answered. The beauty of the Casa is that it's a universal house of love. And God is not a religion. God is a relationship. The development of love for self and for all of our brothers and sisters. Getting in touch with our very essence, which is love. And to realize that we're all part of something so much bigger, incomprehensible. Just as God is. And we need to pray. pray more, because when we pray, we open up a dialogue, a relationship with the one who loves us the most, our Creator. Call him, her, what you like. God is a pretty good word. And it's a two-way street. God always answers our prayers and gives us what we need. And what we think we need and what we actually need are usually poles apart. So let us just sit, follow our breathing. Breathe in this amazing life force, this gift from God. And breathe out all of our worries, our problems, our challenges. And be filled with the presence of our Creator, whose love for us knows no bounds. Let us talk to the sacred trinity of innumerable names and awaken to our interconnectedness with this omnipresent, omniscient, all-encompassing God consciousness. Dear God, I spent so much time looking for you, and I didn't know where you were. I gazed at the infinite and I couldn't see you, and I thought to myself, do you really exist? I wasn't pleased with the search, and I went on. I tried to find you in religions and temples, but you weren't there. I searched for you through priests, pastors, and healers, and I couldn't find you. I felt lonely, empty, and desperate. I disbelieved. And in my disbelief, I offended you. In offending, I stumbled. In stumbling, I fell. In falling, I felt weak. Weak, I looked for help. In help, I looked for friends. With my friends, I found affection. In affection, I witnessed love being born. With love, I saw a new world. And in this new world, I decided to live. What I got, I decided to give. Giving something, I received a lot. And in receiving, I felt happy. Being happy, I found peace. And being in peace, I saw that you were inside of me. Without looking for you, I found you at last.
Bye.
all roads lead to God. And God is never closer to us than during our spiritual battles, which are raging now, both here on earth and in the higher planes. Many of the entities of the Casa, Dom Ignacio, Saint Rita, they went through their spiritual desolation, where they felt distanced from God. And this is when God really is present in our lives. And back in biblical times, even, the question was always, who is God? It's a very loaded question indeed. Even when Moses talked to God at the burning bush, he asked him his name. And God replied merely, I am that I am, referring to his self-existence, the being of beings, eternal and unchangeable. All things change. God is the only constant. So let us take time out now in our busy lives and let God speak to us, whoever or whatever you perceive God to be, the God of your life, the sacred trinity of innumerable names. And this is why it's very important to have our eyes closed, to absorb these beautiful words of comfort, hope, faith from our Creator. I am always with you, even when you do not sense my presence. I love you always, even when you do not love yourself. I include you in abundant opportunities for living, even though you often focus on failure. I am aware of your every need, although my perception of your need may be very different from your own. I listen to your problems and offer you solutions, although these solutions may come in the form of new perspectives you refuse. I hear your prayers and answer them according to your heart's truth. I am the light and the thoughts in your mind. I am the sight in your eyes. I am the life in your body. I am the feeling in your heart. I am always at work in your life for your greater good. It is I who grant you the serenity, courage, and wisdom. Eventually, you will realize the samplings of love that I bestow on you through others. These are intentionally designed to draw you closer to me. It is my eternal hope for you that you will grow constant in your truth and mine. That you may discover my will within each present moment. As you think and act with integrity, humility, and courage. Trusting in me, you will discover the secret of opening your heart to my love. The greater your faith in me, the more I am able to fill your heart with my love. It is only I who loves you unconditionally. I am an ever-flowing fountain of love, peace, and joy. I will never disappoint you. I will always be with you. As you meet with pain, I will turn it into compassion. As you meet with disappointment, I will turn it into hope, courage, and endurance. As you suffer harm from others, I will teach you to forgive. As you realize the errors of your ways and sincerely regret the pain you have caused others, I will forgive you and teach you the gift of mercy. You are my precious child. I will have you be wise and caring in all ways. Let us pray. O Holy One, may your grace and purity be with us. May we see the unity in all creation. May there be tolerance on earth. May the springs of the earth give water to all. May we be nurtured with love. May your will bring us into harmony and the sorrows of yesterday be forgotten. Make us children within our own hearts and heirs to your eternal peace. Amen.
Be not afraid.
Let us relax into our physical bodies now, with his presence of the divine always with us. As you give, so it be given you. We are open to receive a deep cleansing now as we keep our eyes closed to the end of the work. In our mind's eye now, let's visualize a waterfall, like the waterfall here at the Casa, the waterfall of Lazarus, where we are reborn, renewed, refreshed, recalibrated, ready for the journey forward. Or any place of sacred running water that you know with all the gifts of Mother Nature. Big blue butterflies helping us with our transformation as we shift dimensions into a whole new earth paradigm of love light. Strong green oak trees purifying our oxygen. Birds of paradise happily, generously serenading us in a divine symphony. Carpets of magnificent cleansing, fragrant roses being kissed by hummingbirds and bumblebees and even more butterflies. Brilliant sunshine and crystal clear waters embodying rainbows of light. Let's all go to this beautiful place together. Bring your family and friends with you and bring those you need to forgive. And those who need to forgive you. This is why we're incarnate right now on earth. We've come through lifetimes to this very moment to let go of anything and everything that no longer serves us, that's stopping us from stepping into our power, our very essence, which is love light, resonating with God consciousness, growing, expanding, multiplying. Forgiveness is unlocking the door to set someone free and realizing we were the prisoner all along. And let's bring anyone who's particularly struggling, and there's so many of our brothers and sisters who are feeling disconnected from God, suicidal, desolate, depressed, abandoned, unloved, unwanted, frustrated, angry, homeless. The children of the world, they're innocent, they don't need to suffer. Our brothers and sisters languishing in migrant camps, we're all children of God, no exceptions. They need to be liberated now. Anyone who's at the mercy of extreme weather, and there are plenty now on earth. The heat is rising. God is merciful and will hear our prayers. All is in divine order. And let's just take this solemn moment now and plant this seed of peace in our hearts. The peace beyond all understanding, the peace of God. Allow it to pour forth from our open hearts, bringing it to all war zones, anywhere our brothers and sisters are suffering in pain or hungry. And let us bring it into the Ukraine right now. And into the minds of the warmongers, helping them to wake up to our divine essence. We're all in this together, children of God. And let's bring medium drown to this high vibration. And anyone who has struggled or is suffering on account of the problems of the castle. And we never forget our brothers and sisters without their physical bodies who need to be liberated into the light, extending this beautiful cleansing healing energy to them also. Every being deserves to be healed, whether we have a body or not. And as we receive this almighty high vibration from on high, pouring into our open hearts, cleansing, healing, nourishing us, taking away all miasmas, all discomfort, disease, disharmony in all of our bodies, mental, physical, emotional, spiritual. Surrender, let go. Let God, the source, the sacred trinity of innumerable names, take it all away. As we emerge cleansed, healed, renewed, refreshed, reborn into the light, the core of our being. Standing, smiling, sparkling, happy in the beautiful sunshine with our family, friends, new friends. No more grudges. Finished. Done. Evaporated. Only the peace of God left. As we rejoice and bask in this glorious high vibration, we're all receiving now. God knows no borders, no boundaries, no time or space. In the words of Dom Ignacio, telling us about God's love for us. God's love shines down upon us like the light rays of the sun. God's love is poured forth lavishly like a fountain, spilling forth its waters in an unending stream. God's delight and joy is to be with the one called God's children, to be with us. God cannot do enough to speak out and show love for us, ever calling us to a fuller and better life, a sharing in divine life. Amen. And as we bask in this omnipotent, omniscient, omnipresent and omnibenevolent power of God Almighty, we are in total gratitude for another opportunity for us to come together. This beautiful collective consciousness, sons and daughters of the Casa, under the banner of the Casa, the house of love, where the medicine is love, as we learn to live by faith and not by sight. And we really ask to feel the presence of God in our lives. Bidden or not, God is always present. We just need to reach out and ask with a contrite heart, and we will receive everything we need and more for this earthly journey, which is so transient, and we forget. We're greatly loved. And thank you, God, for sending all of your messengers of love, so many angels, archangels, guardian angels, unseen beings, elevated spirits, ascended masters, and these phenomenal entities of light and love working with us 24/7. With the Christ consciousness, which is all about love and forgiveness. And they too have bodies once or twice. They know all about the human condition. They know all about us. They went through their dark night of the soul, like many of us are experiencing through these turbulent times. And they see our suffering and they know exactly what we need. They walk with us, brothers and sisters in the light. God will never abandon his children. And thank you for sending our brother Jesus, Prince of Peace, the light of the world, and our Divine Mother Mary, Queen of Peace, their sacred hearts beaming out their love light to all of us in this valley of tears, helping us to wake up to our divine essence, to realise that life is oh so short, the blink of an eye, and we've been here so many times, down through the ages, to learn these lessons in this, the school of life, and they're not easy right now, and they will be repeated until they're learned. And we're not alone. We have professionals working with us. If we would only realise how much we were loved. And when this earthly life is over, the lessons are learned, we will be liberated into the open arms in the celestial fields with all of these holy beings, where there's no more pain and no more suffering. How great is that? And to all of you, my beautiful, brave, courageous brothers and sisters, pilgrims on the path, for time and time again coming together in this solemn hour or so, necessary divine connection. Thank you for your dedication, your commitment, your courage. And it takes guts to walk this path. It's a choice between love and fear. Fear is the thief of our peace. Keep choosing love. Thank you for your faith, your hope, your patience, your humility, your true grit, and your love and your light. To be in service in all things for the greater glory of God, written on the walls of the Entities Room in English and in Portuguese to remind us of how to navigate these challenging times on earth. The motto of the Jesuits. Dom Ignacio went through his desolation as well, his separation from God, and triumphed. He is with us. As we celebrate with him. Always, but next week is his anniversary of his liberation into the spirit world. He is with us 24/7. Faith moves mountains, and your faith is healing you, your family, your friends, all of those around you, and Mother Earth, and your love and your light beaming out from your open hearts is changing the world forever for the better. We are the change we need to see in the world. We are the ones we have been waiting for. Rise up. Warriors of the light, soldiers of the Christ consciousness. We have nothing to lose but our chains. Never see a need without doing something about it. Nothing can harm a hair on our head. Each hair is counted. And Jesus reminds us, if we knew how much we were loved, we wouldn't be sleeping. Stay elevated. We're just walking each other home. You're doing an amazing job. Thank you. Let us pray with open hearts, without ceasing. joyfully, happily, trustingly, faithfully, knowing that our prayer has been answered always and in all ways as we surrender to the will of God. And today, we say a prayer from St. Augustine, who was a great influence on Dom Ignacio. He's an entity of the Casa. And bear in mind that this was written in 350 AD, over 1,700 years ago. And it resonates with us, possibly more today than ever, reminding us that God does not change. When I seek my God, I seek not corporal grace, nor transient beauty, nor splendor, nor melodious sound, nor sweet fragrance of flowers, nor odorous essence, nor honeyed manna, nor grace of any form, nor anything pleasing of the flesh. None of these things do I seek when I seek my God. When I seek my God, I seek a light exceeding all light which the eyes cannot see. A voice sweeter than all sound which the ear cannot hear. A sweetness above all sweetness, which the tongue cannot taste. A fragrance above all fragrance, which the senses cannot perceive. A mysterious and divine embrace, which the body cannot feel. For this light shines without radiance. This voice is heard without striking the air. This fragrance is perceived though the wind does not bear it. This taste inebriates with no palate to relish it. And this embrace is felt in the center of the soul. Amen. Love. Loving love. Namaste.